hardly.
No, no.
So we came out to get our own jellyfish instead of buying them. You know that new vitamin they have that is from jellyfish to help you retain your.
They extract creams from jellyfish.
Yes. Jelly.
Yeah. And we're 100% Scottish, so we do our own. We're cheap as hell.
Well, when you heard about the jelly, are you less inclined to run out there?
I mean, no, I will not go out there because they had man of war. The tentacle could go up to like 20 feet.
I can assure you, they're not man.
Okay. Well,
you're about 15 from the edge. Maybe you should move back a little.
I might go up like to here, and if I see those people up there start running, I'll stay back. So that's how I'm going to call it.
Yeah, I'm staying away from the water.
Now your children, they're splashing around a little bit.
A little bit, yes.
Are they limited as to how far they can go?
Yes, with arm's reach.
Jellyfish, as many people know, are almost completely dictated by the environment that they're in. They don't do a lot of swimming. So if we get an onshore current for multiple days in a row, we'll start seeing them drift into the area. If we have a lack of lateral current or we have no storm surge or anything, they're just gonna kind of float to shore. And that's why we're seeing a lot of them come into the beach area and a lot of bathers getting stung. Jellyfish stings range from very minor, somewhat painful, to the potential for anaphylactic shock, which is respiratory distress, hives, itching, welts. For the most part, we haven't had any major injuries. Most of it is superficial, some welting, some small little red bumps, and some moderate pain, but no major incidents as of yet. If they're still on the beach, they can flag down a lifeguard or one of our beach safety vehicles that has lifeguard personnel in it, and we treat the area with white distilled vinegar. We're gonna advise the person to go seek further medical attention if they have anything worse than just a rash or any pain that's gonna last longer than an hour or two.